Extracting a conduit from point cloud is as easy as clicking a button. Go to the Scan to BIM tab in Revit and click on Fit Conduit button. Next, click on a point on a conduit that you want to extract. Make sure to click on the straight portion of the conduit, away from elbows, T's, or any other object. In a few seconds, the add-in will extract the conduit and display a pop-up. The pop-up shows a 3D view on the left where you can verify the fit between the extracted conduit and the point cloud. Clicking on Reset View button resets the orientation of the view so that you are examining the cross-section of the conduit again. On the right side, you'll see the conduit's detected diameter. Below, you can select the conduit's level and type. The table shows a list of conduits loaded into the project ordered by best fit first. Delta column shows the difference between the detected diameter and the outer diameter of the conduit. Select a conduit that you want to model and click on the OK button to create the conduit. Let's try extracting one more conduit, which is slightly more difficult for the add-in to extract. As you can see, the conduit that the add-in extracted doesn't match the point cloud at all. In such cases where there are small conduits that are running in parallel, it's possible for the add-in to get confused. In such cases, use the Polygon Crop tool to isolate the points belonging to the straight portion of the conduit and then extract the conduit. Click on Polygon Crop button. Now draw a convex polygon around the conduit of interest as close to it as possible and press Escape. You should only see points within the polygon now. It's better to change the orientation of the view slightly to confirm that there are no points directly in front of the conduit that didn't get cropped. Now extract the conduit using the Fit Conduit tool. When you are done extracting the conduit, click on Clear Crop button. Do not undo the operation using Ctrl Z, otherwise further extraction may not work. Make sure to use Clear Crop button to undo the cropping of the points. Here are three conduits that we have already extracted using the Fit Conduit tool. Now we want to connect them. It's easier to connect the conduits when the point cloud is hidden in the view. So let's click on Show Hide Point Clouds button to hide the point cloud. Note that this step is optional. Connecting the conduits will work the same irrespective of whether the point cloud is hidden or visible. Conduits extracted using our Scan to BIM add-in will fit very well with the point cloud. But Revit may not allow connecting them if their axes are not in the same plane. As you can see in the video, we are not able to connect the two conduits using Trim Extend to Corner tool. To connect the two extracted conduits, we'll need use the Align and Connect tool provided in our Scan to BIM add-in. But before that, you need to make sure that the conduit elbows and transitions are already loaded. You can verify that by selecting a conduit, clicking on Edit Type and making sure that elbow and transition fittings are defined. If not, you'll first need to load the appropriate families in Revit and configure them here. To connect the conduits, click on Align and Connect button. Then select all the conduits in a run that you want to connect. Make sure to select them in the same order in which they are supposed to be connected. In other words, Conduit 1 will connect to Conduit 2, Conduit 2 will connect to Conduit 3 and so on. Once you are done selecting all the conduits in a run, press Escape. The Scan to BIM add-in will optimize the conduits and the angles between them so that they connect with each other with minimal error. It should be pretty quick, but it can take up to 20 seconds when some elbows are more than 90 degrees or conduits are almost but not exactly in a straight line. Once it's done, it will show a pop-up listing the conduits which seem to be forming a T connection and not an elbow. You will need to add the T connections manually. In some cases, such as in the video, the add-in may misidentify a connection as T instead of an elbow. Just connect them using an elbow using Revit's Trim/Extend to Corner tool. Now let's check the other connection. You can see that the add-in automatically added a reducer and an elbow to connect the two conduits.